for the money here in Hollywood. I'll have to call another agent. I'll call another agent. Would you tell him he smells like balls? Even when I talk to him, he smells like balls. Roberto,
I can imagine
what I do in a hot tub with a Hawaiian backdrop. That's just not enough money.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I'm willing to do that for $4,000 and we have a deal then. No bondage. No bondage or S&M or top skin, nothing like that. Okay. We have a deal? Okay, good. I'm about 2 blocks away. I'll come down and sign this finalized.
Founding members, and I was the original singer of The Virus. Well, it's been a long time, but if I remember, we were toying around with a bunch of different names. Me and the original drummer, Jared, and Chris, who was the original guitar player, we had a list of a bunch of different names. And I came across this book that had titles of horror movies from the 50s and the 60s, and started just writing down names like one was The Antics, which is the name we were going to go with, and there was like a few others, and Virus was one of the ones on the list. And we decided we didn't want to go with The Annex. I think there was another band that was using the name, so we went with The Virus, just process of elimination out of this horror movie database book with a bunch of titles. We all kind of knew each other, the original band being Jared, myself, Fat Dave, Chris, and Jeff. This was the original band. We'd all knew each other from shows. I knew Jared for years, knew Fat Dave for years. They were playing in a band called Bomb Squadron at the time. And Chris was playing in a band called US Expulsion. And Jeff was just a friend of mine who I knew from hanging out. And we would just go to shows, and I would say, we should get a band together, we should fucking do something. We were all listening to, Discharge, English Dogs, kind of like the heavier punk stuff. And there really was no band at the time in the Philadelphia area that was playing that style. There just wasn't. At the time, the bands that were like the, for lack of a better word, the street punk bands or the spiky haired bands, they were all kind of singing about drinking beer and haircuts and boots and yelling oi every 5 minutes. And we wanted to do something a little bit more serious, a little bit more political, and we decided we were going to get a band together. So before it got serious, we just said, you know, hey, let's just, you know, rent out a practice space and let's just see what happens. You know what I mean? Let's just see how it goes. And it was just fucking, it just took off. I mean, the first practice we had, you know, we wrote a song pretty much. We started toying around with some covers like Crucifix, you know, some old bands, and it just fucking clicked, and that was it. And then soon after, Jared and Fat Dave left Bomb Squadron, and the band was a full-time band. Chris left U.S. Expulsion, and we were practicing every week in South Philadelphia. And we started getting shows, like, pretty quick.
Right, so this is the last song. I might not be back here for a while. It's been a long time. You know it, sing it. The song's called Battles. This song's for you guys, all your friends, and the ones keeping punk alive.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Let's do your song.
There he is.
Watch out.
There he goes. Where's the magic?
Cheese. Yeah.
It doesn't eat much. What about you guys? You guys, it needs a home. It doesn't eat much.
Come on, guys.
Come on, guys.
Cheer up for the kid.
Good night, Joe! Good night, Joe! Shit it! Straight ahead! Magoo! 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 He was like... Mom? Holy
shit!
Mom,
have I eaten? Did you drop that? Come on, buddy. Did you drop that dick? I think you did. He dropped the dish. He did it. Yes, you did.
Oh, This is Dakota, also with Jesse. All right, you guys, we're here with the Lower Class Brats. If you are just now tuning in, all right, you guys, want to introduce yourself? Tell us who you are.
We're nobody.
Maybe what you play. Paul, you guys been around?
I played myself for 10 years, and it's going pretty good, and I'm getting paid for it now. It's all right.
That's Bones, the singer.
Marty Volume, guitar, 10 years.
Evo, played bass.
Why the name Lower Class Brats?
Lower Class Brats came out of a Germs liner notes from the Germicide LP. They called the Germs and all their fan club a bunch of Lower Class Brats. That's where the name came from.
What got you guys into punk music, or just into punk itself?
Into punk music?
Yeah.
It gets being pushed around a lot. Doesn't think that's going to happen to most of us. Isn't that what got you into punk rock?
I guess.
listen to a lot of bands. I mean, just nothing got me into punk. I think punk was more, you know, rebellion and a stance in the time I grew up. You know, it's like I grew up with different music than punk rock, you know, like, you know, Cheap Trick and, you know, it's like a lot of rock and roll type bands like Kiss and, you know, AC/DC and stuff like that. When punk rock came around, I thought it was the only rebellion that I saw going on, and, you know, Kiss was dying, AC/DC was dying, yeah. All those bands, and, you know, in the 80s were kind of dying out, and punk rock was there, and you jump on the wagon when you're 13 and take where, you know, let ride with it wherever it goes, you know.
So is punk still relevant today, and is punk dead, Bones? And emo.
I'm gonna go to sleep.
No, it's not dead. Never has been.
Punk hasn't been dead since we started. We're the only band keeping it alive. Can't you tell?
This is a punk rock show, not a matinee of early movies. Who controls the fucking media?
Like, somebody who's trying to start a band? Like any kind of like inspiration or something?
I think, you know, the best thing you can do is, like, you know, just keep doing what you're doing, you know? I mean,
yeah.
Keep it going, don't bow down to anybody, and, like, you know, it's like, just keep your scene alive, and pardon me?
My parents totally hate the music I listen to.
Well, of course you're going to hate the music you listen to. You're 15, you know? You're in the most rebellious stage of your life. Of course you're going to hate it, you know? My parents hated me at that point in time, and I hated them too, but...
Yeah, if your parents don't hate it, there's something wrong.
Yeah, if it's too loud, you're too old, right? Well, I appreciate that, man. It's like, just keep doing what you're doing, man. That was very cool. I appreciate that, man. That's awesome to hear. You know, keep doing what you're doing, you know? Just keep going, like, keep playing your own music, and, you know, it's like, you'll get noticed, you know, you'll get the gigs, and everything will be cool, and hopefully, you know, it's like, we'll probably be opening up for you in the next 3 years.
Awesome, man.
Hey, have a good night, bro.
All right, let's go, Ryan. This next song goes to the Spiky Hair Kids, who get the shit kicked out of every show. Regular people. It's called For the Punks. Today, pray for you, pray for everyone, power of God.
Sasha Rose. I play drums.
I'm Justin, and I try to play guitar and sing.
I'm Matt, and I play bass.
We started in 2003.
September of 2003.
We started with the Hairy Walrus in our band, but then we got rid of him, dodged a bullet, and fled to New Mexico.
And Justin started playing guitar. And then we became a three-piece. And pretty much ever since then, we've just been touring, recording, trying to do what we love.